oldest daughter is Christina. She's 12. Jack is 10. Jack was always complaining about his belly hurting. He often didn't feel right and complaining about, I don't feel good. He was always constipated, or he would flip from constipated to diarrhea.
Just the pain like went over me, and I really wasn't one of the best times.
And he actually turned out to be Crohn's at the time.
Crohn's disease, in brief, is a condition that involves our immune system, in which the immune system, some switch gets flipped on, and it acts in a aggressive and abnormal way and attacks itself, so it attacks the body. And the area that it attacks most is the gastrointestinal tract, and it can attack other organ systems, the liver, the eyes, the bones, the joints, the skin. So the entire immune system is turned on in an aggressive and not in a good way, even though involving a very small area of his GI tract had dramatic effects on his overall growth and development.
And he had spent a whole year of no growth, no gain weight. During this time period that Jack got diagnosed with Crohn's, Christina had started with joint pains. Over the 6 months that it took to actually diagnose her, it started moving around. Her neck hurt, or her shoulder hurt, or her back hurt, so it was her hip. We thought it was an injury from her horseback riding. She was also having this loose diarrhea that was occasionally happen, but not every day, not every week.
Just like my belly would be hurting so much, I would be rolling in the bed, wouldn't want to do anything.
He diagnosed us with colitis. When Dr. Goh came out and told me that, I thought like the floor just fell from underneath me. I just sobbed. The future seemed so hard. It's not an easy road of Crohn's can take you.
And you're on no medications?
So as long as she... And it was at that time that he says, well, we're doing this pilot research. Do you know anything about the specific carbohydrate diet? I'm like, no, but you're talking about diet? I want to know more. I was all in from the get-go.
The specific carbohydrate diet looks at a nutritional approach to managing the disease. There are specific types of carbohydrates, in essence sugars, that can, when given, selectively inhibit and or enhance certain types of bacterial species. So in essence, the diet predisposes the particular person who's on that diet to a better mix, if you will, of good bugs than bad bugs in their intestine.
When you look at the diet, it is healthy food. They become good eaters long term.
The specific carbohydrate diet focuses on eliminating certain types of carbs.
Refined sugars are out, no complex carbohydrate, no grains. So no wheat, no gluten of any form, corn, potato, and soy.
And focusing more on simple sugars that are much easier to digest.
Vegetables, fruits, and protein. It eliminates a lot of the junk food. Anything packaged is usually not gonna work. It just takes a little more work, but it's so much worth it. My husband has IBD, it has Crohn's. So I've seen him in many medications, and I see how hard it is to take medications, the side effects, the fatigue that comes along with a lot of medication. If we could put it in remission with diet, it was just make sense. It was an easy sell for me, especially for the kids, because of long-term consequences of medication.
There are certain circumstances where you really don't have a choice, and you gotta hit them hard with pharmacologic therapy that's gonna get them into remission and really get them out of a fairly critical medical situation. But in a lot of circumstances, that nutritional support alone can both put the disease into remission and can enhance growth and development. Both kids, by putting them on the diet, were able to resolve their specific types of Crohn's. Crohn's disease, if you will.
For Christina, it means she's completely healthy. She has no symptoms. For Jack, it means that he actually has grown and he's gaining weight. It was amazing to see that when you had a child that hadn't grown in a year.
I think it's actually a changing epidemiology of this condition in that it's increasing in its frequency in the general population.
I felt like the diet was the one thing that gave me back control.
One of the things that we don't know enough about this diet is, how long do you keep them on it? Do they stay on it for the rest of their lives? Are there ways to sort of modify the diet over time, or do you have to stick with that strict carbohydrate diet forever and ever? And again, that's a critical question that needs to be answered with long-term studies. There's some really important questions, and the only way to answer those things are many more children, carefully studied in well-designed controlled trials that are going to allow us to be able to look at these specific diets and the interventions and what happens to patients over time.
I've seen our life change from where we were a year ago to today, and I know how the change has been so incredible that I'm 100% believer that this will convince other doctors that it is viable form treatment for many patients with diabetes.
If we really can alter diet and then change the microflora, meaning even preventing the disease from occurring, that's incredibly powerful.